Next the mountaintop, Versace's got them winning. Nonstop, the Civic Center's filling. The hilltop's all the buzz now.
The most interesting feeling was, I looked at him, I said, I know what good players you are. I know what great kids you are. I was trying to think what I could do to beat them. And and that's an interesting feeling, really, because here are some class kids. And as they were talking to me, I was trying to say, Les, what do I have to do to stop you this year?
It was off to Omaha, Nebraska in the first meeting ever of Versace against Baroni, Bradley against Creighton. And you knew he'd have the Blue Jays jacked, and they were. They were marvelous in the first half and would have led 32-30, but
6 seconds to go in the half. The ball is rolled to half court, and Manuel picks it up with six. Hawk with five, now with four. With three, fires with two. Too hard. Good! Off the glass and in! Boy, oh boy, he's making a habit of this. 32-32.
Tony said on the way to the locker room, well, at least he's made his miracle shot in the first half. This game was to feature the brilliant play of Greg Jones. He had a career-high 11. And a balanced attack had a sick Jim Les leading the way with 16, and the Braves had won their 20th and 11th in a row. They returned home to watch Richard Dent and the Bears become world champions. It was time for another road trip to Amarillo and Tulsa. First off, the last game ever against West Texas State in the Panhandle. The Braves started to rise in the polls, but Dick kept preaching the philosophy of one at a time and that the next game was the most important of the season. Bradley beat the Buffs 63-54 and prepared for the noon TV rematch with Tulsa. J.D. Barnett's team knew that realistically to stay in the league race, they would have to win. But Bradley liked that situation and played the game like it was the last of the year. Mike led the way with 18, and the defense was outstanding, both on the full and the half court. Protecting a one-point lead late, Jimmy saw an opening but charged. But Tracy Moore missed a shot to take the lead for the Hurricane, and Les was fouled. With 6 seconds to go, the ball would once again bounce Bradley's way on his free throw. And the Braves had their 13th in a row, 22nd overall, 9-0 in the Valley, and waved goodbye to the rest of the league. Of note, 6'11 Brian Riley didn't play in this game. He would be ready when Bradley would visit again in March. The second sellout of the year came to see Tony Baroni bring in his Creighton Blue Jays. Sports Illustrated's Jaime Diaz covered the game, and it was showtime for Len Bertolini. Always first on the floor in warm-ups, Lenny hit his first six shots. He finished with 14, and the Hawk had 23. Bradley won by 20. And moved to 12th in the polls with a trip to normal the next Monday night. Round two against the Redbirds was shown nationally on ESPN. They'd all get a taste of the I-74 rivalry. This game, no question, belonged to Donald Powell. He had 15 points and was all over the offensive boards. Bradley won their 15th straight, 74-67, 24-1. What followed were wins at Indiana State and Southern Illinois, where the Braves had to defend the last shot and come from eight down with two to play to get a winner from who else. With Drake coming to Carve Arena the next Thursday, the magic number one, it was time for a clincher. Everyone shined, especially JT. And for the fifth time in the school's history, the third in 7 years, it was time to cut him down.
He goes by Dahlke, put it up. It's blocked by Mike Williams. Melvin Mathis gets the rebound up good. With five, with four, 88-79, the final score. Mike Williams throws the ball into section 21. At the beginning of the year, the Braves were picked to win the Missouri Valley Conference Championship. And they were right.
The title propelled Bradley's name even further nationally, and there was no letdown in less than 48 hours against the Wichita State Shockers in the Valley TV game. The Braves won 74-64 and were led in rebounding by the unsung hero of the team the entire year, Trevor Trippett. He had 9 for the day and entered the triple-triple club, 100 points, rebounds, and assists. The only dark note on this Saturday was a sprain to the ankle of the emerging JT. The final home game was senior night. The now 11th-ranked Braves are going for their 20th straight. They defeated the Sycamores 71-51 to go to 29-1. And the great thing about Bradley basketball is just when you think there'll never be another Tom Less, there's a Willie Scott. And just when you thought there'd never again be a Roadrunner, comes Jimmy Less. And just when you thought no one could ever replace Jim.
That breaks the Bradley run. 6 points now for him. Oh, did they ever, did Trevor ever flatten Gillespie?
Beautiful. Pass Anthony Manuel, good for Frank Jones.
Beautiful pass from Anthony Manuel.
And he's fouled. Taking down Jones, into Manuel. 3-on-3, break at the other end. Please, Anthony Manuel, kaboom! There we go.
But this was a night to pass the torch, and it was sad to say so long.
It's been a long year. It's been a fun year. It's been a real learning experience, the type of experience you can carry on in life. That's going to be my last collegiate game ever. It'll be the last time I play in Peoria ever. I'm not going to want to say goodbye. I'm not going to say goodbye. I'll just say see you later.
And every time I came out, you know, I didn't always have a great night or a good shooting night or I, you know, turn the ball over or something. But I was always going to give 110% because I felt that that's what, you know, the people deserve and that's what they came to see. As far as coming out the last time, next Thursday, you know, until recently when I started thinking about it, I didn't know the answer. And it's really going to be strange not to think of myself not coming out on the court anymore. It's really going to be strange.
I've had no problems with this team whatsoever. They're the most incredibly cooperative group of young men that I've ever worked with. And this profession, when you have the kinds of problems that you read about sometimes, it makes it the toughest and worst job in the world. But when you have a group of lads like I have this year, it makes it the best job in the world. And they've just been an absolute delight, and I love them all very much, and I will never forget them. They put together one of the most incredible years, maybe, when you consider a lot of things, and as we're looked at in the future, in collegiate basketball, for what they were able to accomplish. In 1986, it will always be in the annals of collegiate basketball that the team that had the best regular season record was the Bradley Braves, comprised of these young men.
Did you know you can get your teeth straightened without having to wear braces?
Ask your dentist about this new technology. If you don't have a dentist, call me, Dr. Walter Gillen, and I would be happy to send you this free brochure explaining this new procedure.
So if your smile is important to you, why not call Dr. Gillen's office today? Dr. Gillen's office is conveniently located at 233 Meadows Avenue in East Peoria. Call 694-0606 for your family's complete dental and orthodontic care.
Tommy Lasorda here, introducing the Honda All-Stars. We've got quite a team this year. Leading off and cutting the infield down to size, the Honda Lawnmower. In the outfield, covering left, center, and right, the Honda Lawn Tractor. Tearing up those baselines, the Honda Tiller. And the Honda Generator, the real power in the lineup. Without it, I wouldn't have any fans.
In Peoria Heights, it's Gamble's Hardware. In Ottawa, it's Leopold Motor Sales. And in Bloomington, Sportland Honda.
How tough is a Tuffy muffler? My assistant has volunteered.
Volunteered?
Certainly, to ride along on a Tuffy torture test.
Volunteered!
Thanks, Bill.
Tuffy stands up to gravel and rock. Tuffy has covered the potholes.
Right, Bill?
And Tuffy resists humidity and salt. That's why Tuffy is warranted for as long as you own your car. Right, Bill?
Right. Can I get down now?
Afraid not, Bill. Tuffy also sells brakes and shocks.
Brakes and shocks.
That's right.
Your grandma didn't make them. The Colonel never tried. The tenderest part of the chicken breast. All natural white meat inside. Sound good to you? They're tender chicken flanks. So plump and batter fried. They come from Long John Silver's. So come on, step inside. Sounds good to me. Long John Silver's.
Next up, the Valley Tournament. In past years, all three games would have been in Peoria. But instead of 32,000 filing through the gates at Carver Arena, a couple hundred loyal fans followed the team to the Assembly Center in Tulsa, Oklahoma for the first game against West Texas State, the 8th seed. More people would later see a practice in Utah than would witness this game with the Buffs and the 9th-ranked Tomahawk Gang. Gary Moss's club gave it everything they had in their last Division I game. But without Orlando Graham, who had left their squad, Mike Williams was a force, and Bradley had its 21st straight and 30th overall, 61-55. For the semifinal game with Illinois State, you could have filled Horton or Carver for $20 a ticket. But even in Oklahoma, the rivalry was just as intense. For the third time, Illinois State would play superbly and led Bradley by 12 with 10 minutes to go, as Derek Sanders provided most of their offense. But Jimmy would lead the team back to within a point. Then ISU continued to keep the heat on. And with just over a minute to go, Mike would get free for a slam inside for his 22nd and 23rd points to get within a point. And when ISU failed to make it three, the Braves had a possession left. They'd been here before.
Now Bertolini with 10, Lance with 9, Hawk with 8, rolls down the lane with 7, scoops it up with 6, makes it with 5, with 4, with 3, with 2, can't put the lane back, they didn't call a timeout, the game's over! It's over again! Hawk has hit the shot! And we dodged the bullet again!
It was just an excellent decision by Hersey, who is the greatest clutch player in America.
In the final, Bradley put their 22-game winning streak on the line against the hosts, trying to beat another team for a third time on their floor, the impossible hat trick. In addition to the fans already there, WMBD's John Williams, along with the morning team of Max and Pam McGann, took in over $6,000 in pledges to send the Bradley cheerleaders who'd opted to go to the NCAA to Tulsa for the final. Well, things started well as the Braves got off to a quick start. The tournament most valuable player, Brian Riley, got the Hurricanes started and they never stopped. Despite the dozen points from Trevor, the weary Braves would lose 74-58 on ESPN. And fans feared the loss would hurt where the team would go and where they'd be seated. But that didn't keep them from the Peoria Airport to welcome their heroes home the next day. And Sunday, they gathered at the Student Center to watch where and against whom. It would be the West Regional, Ogden, Utah, against the University of Texas, El Paso. They were seated 10th, Bradley 7th. Disappointed again, but the approach was much different.
Now, when you have a disappointment in life, you can do one of two things. You can either let it beat you down, or you can fight back. And I guarantee you, we're going to fight back.
The fight would take place in the beautiful mountains at the base of the Great Salt Lake in Ogden, Utah, on the campus of Weber State College. Bradley's last win of the year would be their best. The team showed all of the spark of the season in one game. Jimmy is leadership. Mike is strength. Trevor is blossoming jumper. Donald is boards. And Hawk, well, Hawk. But the game was decided when Jerry Thomas made his appearance. And Bradley won 83-65, winning its first NCAA game in 31 years. The next day, the team prepared for the Louisville Cardinals, a team destined for Dallas. The Braves and the Cardinals, the memories of that game in the fieldhouse came back again. But this was a different era, different teams. Bradley hung with the deep Cardinals 35 minutes and led by as many as six in the first half, 16-10. But behind Milt Wagner and Billy Thompson, two lock first round.